Hello children, we meet again in part 3 of comparing quantities. In this part, we are going to learn how to find increase or decrease in percentage. Now, what does increase or decrease in percentage mean? See, you must have heard many sentences like the Pantaloons are giving a 50% discount on its item. So, how to find that percentage on the printed price on a particular item? So how to find how much amount has been decreased and how much amount has been increased? So in this part, we are going to find increase or decrease in percentage. We are going to find how to learn how to find discount and discount percentage. We are also going to learn how to find cost price, selling price, or profit percentage and loss percentage. So all these things we are going to learn in this part 3, which is based on finding increase or decrease in percentage. So let's begin with an example to understand it better. So Rahul goes to a shop to buy a bag as various discounts were offered. So Rahul goes to a shop where various discounts were offered on various types of bags. On some bags 10% was offered, some bags 25% was offered. He selected a bag of rupees 3,400 on which there was a discount of 25%. So he is selecting a bag on which there was a discount of 25%, and that bag, the printed price, you can see the tag of price on it, and that printed price was rupees 3,400. So you should know how much amount is reduced on this 3,400, and that is what we are going to learn in this part. How to find the discount amount given to you, offered to you. So what amount did Rahul pay? First of all, we write down price of the bag. Now what was the price, original price of the bag? 3,400. So you write down how much discount was offered? 25%. Now this 25% means how much amount? So let's find out discount amount and equate it like 25% of 3,400. Discount amount is what? 25% of this original price. So this 25% is what? 25 upon 100 into 3,400. 0 and 0 gets cancelled, you get 25 into 34. So the amount, 25% of 3,400 is rupees 850. That means this much amount is reduced on the printed price of the bag. What is the meaning of discount amount? Discount amount means itna amount kam ho gaya on rupees 3,400. Now, so how much Rahul has to pay? The new price he has to pay for. So new price for Rahul was old price minus discount amount. And instead of new price, you can also write Rahul paid old price minus discount amount. Old price was rupees 3,400 minus rupees 840, because this was the discount given to him. And that is equal to rupees 2,550. So the Rahul pays rupees 2,550. So now you know how to calculate the discount amount. So now when you go to the shop and you are offered certain discount on a printed price, you first calculate how much amount is reduced. Then from the printed price, you minus that amount and you get how much amount you have to pay. I hope you all are clear. Once again, I repeat, whenever a discount is given, first find the discount amount. That means convert the percentage into amount. And that, how will you convert? Whatever amount, 25% of the printed price. And find that amount, and that amount you subtract from the printed price or the marked price, and you will get rupees whatever you have to pay after getting a discount. So you can also calculate by yourself. Sometimes if you don't know, you have to rely on the shopkeeper. But now you know how to convert the discount percentage into amount and find how much you have to pay. Let's take what is discount. Let us understand first a theory about discount. So discount is the reduction. Discount is the reduction given on the marked price. Whatever is the printed price on that, this reduction is given and that is known as discount. जो भी printed price है उसमें कितना कम करके देते हैं उसको discount. You know, when you go to a shop, you must have many times heard your mother say, and how much discount you are going to give, isn't it? That means how much reduction you will give, that is called discount. And this is generally given to attract the customers to buy goods or to promote sales of the goods. And this discount is generally given to the customer to buy goods or to promote sales of the goods. That means to attract. You know, whenever you hear, oh, this shop is giving 50% discount, 60% discount, I will go. You know, nowadays on the television also you get Amazon 70% discount, isn't it? And Amazon great sale, it has come. Why? To attract the customers, isn't it? So discount is what? Marked price minus the sale price. So how to find how much discount you are given? Whatever was the marked price, from that you subtract the sale price and you will come to know how much discount you are given. You know, when on Amazon or when you click on 70% discount, it is given 3000 and then it is cancelled and something else is written, rupees 1500. So you come to know that how much discount you are given. You are given a discount of 1500. That means from 3000, when you subtract 1500, you get 1500. So marked price minus the sale price, you come to know how much discount is given. Now, how to find percentage discount? You come to know, sometimes you are given, you come to know the discount amount, and then you have to convert into percentage. How to do that? So we will understand that by an example. An item marked at rupees 840. The printed price on the item was rupees 840. But it is sold for rupees 714. It is sold for only 714. Reduced rate it is sold at. So how much discount is given? And what is the discount percentage? So first, to find the amount of discount, marked price minus the sale price, which is rupees 840 minus rupees 714. So what do you get? You get rupees 126. So discount percentage will be equal to discount upon marked price into 100. So 0 and 0 gets cancelled and 2 5s are and 2 42s are. After that 42 1s are and 42 3s are. So 3 into 5 is equal to 15%. You have to remember this formula. Discount percentage, to convert the discount amount into discount percentage, it is discount upon marked price into 100. So that is 126 upon 840 into 100. After the cancellation, you get 15%. It is very simple, isn't it? So let's move to the next example. The list price of a frock, that means the marked price or the list price or the printed price, everything is same. So the list price of a frock is rupees 220. A discount of 20% is announced on sales. So when it is going for a sale, it was sold at 20% discount. So what is the amount of discount on it and its sale price? So marked price rupees 220, like we saw in the case of Rahul when he is going to buy the bag. Discount given is 20%. So first find the discount amount. Discount amount is 20% of 220. When instead of 20%, I will write it as 20 upon 100 into 220. So 0, 0 gets cancelled. This 0 and this 0 gets cancelled. And 2 into 22 is equal to rupees 44. Now the sale price. That means how much price it was sold at. So sale price is equal to marked price minus discount. Marked price was what? Rupees 220. So rupees 220 minus rupees 44. This is discount. Discount is always subtracted. And you get rupees 176. So the sale price was rupees 176. So the discount given was rupees 44 and the sale price is rupees 176. That means discount amount. Already the percentage discount was given to you. Now sometimes after you buy something, you have to do some additional expenses. Like if I bought a refrigerator, then to bring that refrigerator from the shop to my house, I have to spend on its transportation. Now this extra expenses are added to the cost price and it is considered as the total cost price. So it will, if I am buying a refrigerator for 15,000 rupees and I am spending 400 on its transportation, then the cost price of that refrigerator for me is 15,400, isn't it? So here that is what is written here. We will just read it. Sometimes when an article is bought, some additional expenses are made while buying or before selling it. These expenses have to be included in the cost price. So these expenses have to be included in the cost price. And sometimes these expenses are referred as overhead charges. Now, what are such expenses? They may include as expenses spent on repairs, labor charges, transportations, etc. So, what are these expenses? They are the expense or the amount spent on repair, labor charges and transportation before selling it. Now, we are going to learn how to find profit percentage and loss percentage that you have already studied in your 6th and 7th standard. It is just a revision and let's again understand it by one example. Sohan bought a second hand refrigerator for rupees 2500 and then spent rupees 500 on its repair. He is buying a second-hand refrigerator for rupees 2500 and is spending 500 on its repair and again sold it for rupees 3300. Find his loss or gain percentage. You already know certain things like when selling price is more than the cost price, then it is a profit. Or when the cost price is more than the selling price, then it is loss. You have also studied these formula. Profit percentage is profit upon CP into 100 and loss percentage is loss upon CP into 100. So first of all, let us write down what was the cost price for Sohan. So cost price for Sohan is the price for which he bought the refrigerator plus the amount he spent on repairs. So rupees 2500 plus rupees 500, that is equal to rupees 3000. Selling price is given, that is rupees 3300, which is greater than the cost price and therefore it is profit. So first find out the profit amount. How much profit? Profit is equal to selling price minus the cost price. So that is equal to rupees 3300 minus rupees 3000. And that is equal to rupees 300. So this was the profit. What are you asked? Profit percent. So profit percent, gain percent means profit percent, which is equal to, first write down the formula, profit upon CP into 100 and that is equal to 300 upon 3000. 3000 was the cost price into 100. Two zeros gets cancelled. Again, one zero and another zero gets cancelled. Three ones are and three tens are 30. So that is equal to 10%. Thus, the profit percentage is equal to 10%. So this is how you will find the profit percent. Now, in the next part, we will again be doing some more examples to understand discount given, VAT, and also sales tax. So till then, stay home, stay safe, and write down all these examples in your classwork book. Thank you.